Well, as you guys know, the most stupid news story of this week was the drama around Rishi Sunak not wearing his seatbelt in the back of the car. Well, we are here to expose some of the media hypocrisy. Right, as you guys know, I am definitely not a fan of Rishi Sunak or his government, and so I'm not defending him or anything that he stands for these days, really. But this drama about the seatbelt gate, especially for those if you're watching from abroad, from a different country, he was sitting in the car making a very cringy video as usual to the camera, to an iPhone or something, and he wasn't wearing a seatbelt. And he got fined for it, about, what, £100 or something, for not wearing a seatbelt in the back of the car. And this became a massive, massive scandal for no reason. Now, you could say, if you want to be, you know, one of those control freaks, you know, follow all the rules and everything, then yeah, that was the scandal. So he didn't wear a seatbelt, he got fined. Let's move on. But those who turned it into the Watergate, that was absolutely chaotic. Let's not forget that this is the same mainstream media, the whole cabal, that didn't say anything when it came to, for example, Jeremy Corbyn sitting in the back of the car, not wearing a seatbelt. What about another one? Tony Blair. Ah, yes, Saint Blair, who also sat in the back of the car, didn't wear a seatbelt, nobody cared. How about Ed Miliband? Do you remember Ed Miliband? No seatbelt for Ed Miliband. How about Peter Mandelson, back of the car, no seatbelt. In fact, their new hero, Keir Starmer, this is a video of him not wearing a seatbelt.
Ben Helen's case has always been very important to me from when I first met them and working with them through the difficult days of the trial.
I just realized how young he looked. This was like last week. This job is making him very, very old. Anyway, on the plus side, for those who are still supporters of Boris Johnson, Rishi Sunak has now managed to out-Boris Boris. So when you look at the fixed penalty notices received by prime ministers, Rishi Sunak is leading by two. Boris has only received one FPN, which is also good news for supporters of Rishi Sunak. Rishi Sunak is finally leading in something. Yeah, in breaking the law. Not really in terms of the actual opinion polls, anything when it comes to popularity or approval ratings. This country is turned, the political side of this country is literally turning into a circus. I mean, it did a while ago, but it's just funny. It's sad, but it's funny. But it's good to point out that Rishi Sunak is ridiculous, but also the mainstream media are hypocrites. And Keir Starmer is getting old every minute. So that's just basically the gist of it, if you didn't pay attention to the video. That's, you just need the last 10 seconds. Anyway, thank you so much for all the support on this channel. Make sure to subscribe and click on the notification bell next to it. I'm Mahyar, Tousi, and we are the media.